Coming soon to theaters.
Hello, welcome to Disc 2 of Finding Nemo. I'm Andrew Stanton, the director of the film.
And I'm Lee Unkrich, the co-director.
You now have two pristine versions of the film direct from the digital source. You have a widescreen version on Disc 1, and here on Disc 2, a full-frame version that fits a standard TV.
But instead of chopping off parts of the frame to make the image fit, we've actually extended the image, so you won't miss anything.
Now, after the movie,
discover the wonder of the ocean by watching Exploring the Reef with Jean-Michel Cousteau.
Then watch our 1989 short film, Knick Knack.
Learn about the real-life fish of Finding Nemo in Mr. Ray's Encyclopedia.
Test your guessing skills with the game Fish Charades.
And kids can listen to a tale of Nemo in story time.
And just like on Disc 1, when you select the fish icon, the menu text will disappear, turning your TV into a virtual aquarium.
And of course, there's a few Easter eggs on this disc as well.
So grab your remote, sit back, and enjoy disc two of Mary Poppins.
Finding Nemo.
Finding Nemo.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. elegance, style, form, function. The AquaScum 2003. Clean tank living.
The AquaScum 2003 hermetically sealed dual-phase motor technology is not for use as air conditioner, fountain, tire pump, pool sweep, water purifier, or laser pointer. Not approved for freshwater fish. The AS2K3 contains a class 3 laser. Warning, laser beams may cause permanent eye damage. Filter canisters contain ammonium nitrate, may cause ichthyological diarrhea, scale wart, cankers, fish gout, and or bloatation. One additional canister filter supplied in EAG-compliant areas if purchased on third Sunday of the month. Free keychain on purchase of 2 or more at participating fisheries.
Amazingly, a full-grown octopus over 2 feet long can squeeze through a hole the size of a quarter.
Wow! Mammals!
Let's go.
Amazingly, a full-grown... Some sharks replace their teeth every 2 to 4 weeks. That's a lot of work for the underwater tooth fairy. Fish don't have eyelids, so never enter a staring contest with a fish. The connection between clownfish and their... Most of the sand on the Great Barrier Reef is the result of parrotfish eating coral and excreting the undigestible crushed limestone. The connection between clownfish and their anemone homes is as amazing as the connection between zooxanthellae and the giant tridacta. You just can't imagine one without... The connection between clownfish and their anemone homes is as amazing as the connection between zooxanthellae and the giant tridacta. You just can't imagine one without the other. You see, clownfish can live among the anemone's stinging tentacles because their bodies are coated with protective mucus. Mucus? Yuck! That's why it's never a good idea to shake fins with a clownfish. Paracantharus hepatus are delightful little creatures. Unusual for the sea, these fish are vegetarians. Like a cow, they digest plant matter by fermenting it in their gut. Also like a cow, their bodies conceal sharp spines, which they use to defend themselves against predators with a... Huh? What? What's that? Oh. Since when? I have just been informed that cows do not have sharp spines concealed on their bodies. So, moving along. Ah, the lovely black and white humbug, also known as the zebrafish. With its striking black and white stripes, some might be tempted to call it the striper, or the vertical blind, or the picket fence in front of coal, or the ebony and ivory fish. You might call it the barcode, or the white bread pumpernickel, white bread pumpernickel, white bread pumpernickel fish. But for me, this fascinating little flipper will always be known as Frank. Zebrasoma flavescens are herbivorous, eating all manner of plant life. Their short snout has evolved for the specialized task of grazing on algae, which grows on rocks. The mouth and surrounding skin has toughened to withstand the impact with the rough reef surface. This modified nose may be great for finding food, but it makes it almost impossible for them to wear glasses. The common name for the Lismata amboinensis is the cleaner shrimp. This aptly describes the amazing role these little creatures play. The cleaner shrimp climb aboard other creatures and pick off parasites. This provides food for the shrimp and keeps the other ocean dwellers healthy. Eating so quickly, the shrimp appear to be beating on their own chest. But recently, scientists have determined that this chest beating is simply the shrimp's way of asking for the check at the end of the meal. The spectacular Zanclus cornutus is an unmistakable fish, with its bold coloration, projecting snout, and dorsal fin augmented with a long filamentous extension. Say that with me, kids. Filamentous extension. The genus name Zanclus comes from the Greek word for sickle, inspired by the sickle-shaped dorsal fin. Gosh, aren't fish names fun? Even the study of fish is fun to say. Ichthyology. Ichthyology. Oh, I love that. The hippocampus cuda, otherwise known as the seahorse, whoa boy, is one of nature's most curious designs. Covered in bony plates, which serve as a kind of armor, these lovely but shy creatures have an unusual method of propulsion. The dorsal fin undulates, acting like a small propeller. Maybe we should call him Helicopterus Cuda. Get it? He's a helicopter. Okay, we're done. The starfish may appear lifeless and motionless, but in fact, they're one of the most dynamic and exciting creatures in the sea. These living wonders move in remarkable ways. But the trick is to be patient. Take it from Mr. Ray. When they move, it's truly worth the wait. Let's watch. Ever so slightly, and... okay, nothing yet. Remember patience. Every movement is like a jewel to be studied. Wait, is that? No, nothing. Oh, who are we kidding? Is this thing even alive? It's like watching algae grow. Oh, forget it. That's enough of this starfish. I've had it up there. After swimming many miles, mother turtles crawl up on the beach to lay their eggs. Once buried in the sand, the mothers leave the eggs and return to the ocean. When the eggs hatch, these feisty little newborns are the very definition of self-reliance. Their remarkable instinct leads them to the ocean, where they swim deep out to sea, searching for their mother to ask, "Hey, what's the big idea leaving us all buried here in the sand, huh? Were you ever gonna come back and check on us?" It's at this point that the mother turtle would send the baby turtle to their room for a timeout. And that, boys and girls, is a little glimpse of why Mrs. Ray and I never had kids. Now, the diadont holocanthus may be cute, but it also happens to be one of the most poisonous fish in the sea. It's known as the puffer fish because when threatened, it puffs up to appear more powerful. To achieve this amazing shape, it fills its body with water to stretch its skin. This pokes out its sharp spines, which make it impossible for predators to ingest them. Unfortunately, once the puffer fish is inflated, it still is at the mercy of others in the ocean, namely the local teenage fish, who use them as volleyballs or floats in the parade. While many think of great white sharks as brutal, cold-blooded killers, the Carcharodon cacarius is actually a brutal, warm-blooded killer. These powerful swimmers can hunt in cold water because they maintain their own temperature. Surprisingly, for a predator this large, they can even launch themselves out of the water to land on prey from above. Isn't that great? No one's safe on land or sea. No one is safe. If anybody needs me, I'll be buried in the sand right over there. Bye! The Grandma Loretto feeds on drifting plankton and small crustaceans. It has the remarkable ability to swim upside down easily. While colorful and attractive, the Royal Grandma is a shy and secretive fish. What secrets does this tiny swimmer hold so tightly? What does a fish know that would make him so secretive? Is there something we don't know that we should know? Hey, little fella, let us in on the secret. Why won't you tell me, you impenetrable Royal Grandma, with your secretive ways? I vow that one day I will discover your secret. Mark my words. Whoa, now there's something I know a thing or two about. Me! With unusually large brains, rays are some of the smartest creatures on the reef, if I do say so myself. Though graceful and majestic, rays are not built for speed. but we can cover ourselves with sand as a clever defense mechanism. Remember, it's harder to get hunted when your predators can't see you. Being crepuscular, most of our activity is in the low light of dawn or dusk. And darkness is no problem for rays because we sense things electrically. In fact, I'm sensing your DVD player right now. Fish don't have eyelids, so never enter a staring contest with a fish.
Dudes, it's time to play a righteous game of fish charades. So who's on board? Just you, or are you cruising with a buddy? Solo. So it shall be written. Let us begin. Listen up, my young ones. If you want to totally rock at this game, these righteous silverfish are going to swim in and start forming shapes. Sweet, huh? I'll say. But wait, get this. Every time these shiny dudes bunch into something, you gotta guess the shape before the jellyfish, like, totally floats to the top. See where I'm going with this whole thing? Uh-huh. The faster you guess, the more points you'll bag. I'll give you four choices to choose from. Got it, dudes? All right, let's rock! What if I said to you, fork, a spoon, a trident, or a ladder? Uh-huh. Ripped, chunked, and cut. Coming at you, player of the moment, are your orbs peeping at a hook? An anchor, an arrow, or scissors? So sweet. Oh, you were so totally robbed! Keep trying, dude! Could this be the one you stumble on? Oh, methinks not. Methinks not at all. So let's do this. Is it a dolphin, a submarine, a torpedo, or an airplane? Uh-huh. Ripped, chunked, and cut.
My name's Dory, and here's my story. I'm from the reef, and I don't eat beef. Come on, join me. You know the words. My name's Dory, and here's my story. I'm from the reef, and I don't eat beef.
Look here. Is it a seahorse, an eel, a wave, or a hook? You know this one, dude. You know how I know? Because I know, and if I know, I know you know, you know. This is when legends are made, in the rematch. Swimming solo, I like your style. Let us begin. Listen up, my young ones. If you want to totally rock at this game, these righteous silverfish are going to swim in and start forming shapes. Sweet, huh? I'll say. But wait, get this. Every time these shiny dudes bunch into something, you gotta guess the shape before the jellyfish, like, totally floats to the top. See where I'm going with this whole thing? Uh-huh. The faster you guess, the more points you'll bag. I'll give you four choices to choose from. Got it, dudes? All right, let's rock! Set your blinkers on this objective. And this is when legends are made, in the rematch. This one's a gimme. Observe. Is it a turtle, a submarine, a fish, or a shark? And this is when legends are made, in the rematch. Okay, wave machine. Is it the sun, or not the moon? Your awesomeness is magnified only by your ability to totally rule.
My name's Dory, and here's my story. I'm from the reef, and I don't eat beef. Come on, join me. You know the words. My name's Dory, and here's my story. I'm from the reef, and I don't eat beef.
Okay, buddy, here we go. Is it an eel, moon, hook, or the seahorse? Oh, I know! Uh-huh, ripped, chucked, and cut. Now what will our little friends do next? Whoa, check it out. Is it a sea snail, a mask, an eel, or a dolphin? Uh-huh, ripped, chucked, and cut. Do not be fooled, my most awesome friend. Are you gazing at a paddle, a rotor, a wheel, or seaweed? Oh, you are so totally robbed! Keep trying, dude!
Hey, what's going on? Oh, looks like a game. I love games! Games are fun!
Okay, I would like to introduce you to a bird, a shark, a moon, or this pointy kind of thing. I hate to back into one of those bad boys. All right, shake that off, try it again. You can do it, dude. Is it a seaweed, jellyfish, an eel, or an octopus? Sweet! Sweet indeed. What if I said to you, fork? We are not worthy to tread the same water.
Hey, what's going on? Oh, looks like a game. I love games! Games are fun! Hey, what's going on? Oh, looks like a game. I love games! Games are fun!
When you're ready to move on in the story, click on the forward arrow. If you'd like to go back in the story, click on the backward arrow. If you want to see and hear a screen again, click on the square with the circle in it. And if you want to exit the story, click on the circle with the X in it. Have fun! And now, Nemo goes to school. Nemo loved school. He loved his classmates, his teachers, and he loved to learn.
Time for school! It's time for school!
Come on, boy, it's time for school.
Oh boy!
Every morning, Nemo's dad, Marlin, would take him to school. Along the way, Nemo loved to ask lots of questions.
Have you ever met a shark?
No, and I don't plan to.
How old are sea turtles?
Why don't you click on Marlin for the answer?
Sea turtles? I met one, and he was 150 years old.
Mr. Ray was everyone's favorite teacher.
Huh, I wonder where my class has gone. Oh, there you are.
If you click on the notes, you can hear Mr. Ray's song.
All Let's name the zones, the zones, the zones. Let's name the zones of the open sea. Oh, seaweed is cool, seaweed is fun. It makes its food from the rays of the sun.
Mr. Ray's lesson was your ocean home.
Well, Nemo, all new explorers must answer a science question.
Okay.
You live in what kind of home?
In an anemone. Okay,
don't hurt yourself.
An anemone.
In Nemo's next class, there was a guest teacher that day.
Hi, I'm Dory.
She was teaching the class how to speak whale. Click on Dory if you want to hear some cool whale speak.
Can you
Then it was time for music class. Click on the instruments to hear what they sound like. Then it was show and tell, and Nemo brought in some special friends.
Hello, my name is Bruce.
Fish are friends, not food.
Well, we'll see you next week.
After the sharks left, it was time to go home.
Remember, fish are friends.
Not food. Bye.
As they swam home, Nemo told Marlin how he couldn't wait to go back to school tomorrow. Marlin had to tell Nemo that he couldn't. Because it was Saturday.
When life gets you down, you know what you gotta do? Just keep swimming, just keep swimming, just keep swimming, swimming, swimming. What do? We swim.
Hi, kids. Welcome to Story Time. If you want to read along with me, click here. If you want to read to yourself, click here.
The new Disney Pixar film, Finding Nemo, is an amazing story about a father searching for his lost son. Now here's the catch. The father and son are both fish. Now let's go deep underwater and meet the heroes of this story. Marlin, his son Nemo, and their friend Dory. Marlin, tell us, how did this adventure begin?
Oh, it's such a long story.
Oh, come on.
All right, Dory. It was Nemo's first day at school, and he was swimming way too far out when he got scooped up by scuba
divers!
No way.
Yeah!
And then
I was in a fish tank in a dentist's office!
Whoa!
You must have been...
Oh, my gosh! Is that a camera? Hi, I'm Dory.
Hi, Dory. So the dentist's office turned out to be all the way in Sydney, Australia. And to get there, you had to fight your way past jellyfish, whales, and sharks, huh? Well, that's tough stuff. So why didn't you just, give up?
Well, we had to say a little pesto.
It's Nemo. Dory has a little trouble remembering things.
That's right. Can't remember diddly. In one ear, out the... Oh, my gosh! Is that a camera? Hi, I'm Dory.
Uh-huh. Marlin, tell us and our viewers here, after crossing the ocean to rescue your son, how do you feel... You really changed as a fish. I mean, you can't go through, you know, something like that and not be affected, at least, you know, internally.
Well, that I was being overprotective with Nemo. Nemo? Nemo!
Ollie,
this
Ollie,
is not funny!
Free.
Get out here right now!
Guido!
Hello, mates!
Ah! Hi, Dad!
Nemo!
There's a lot of stuff in here! A shoe, a bike, a
Nemo,
shovel.
Please swim out of the razor-sharp teeth!
Hey, I just had them cleaned!
Marlin, our viewers would love to know exactly how Nemo was rescued.
Oh, well, you know, we really shouldn't give too much away.
You can give us a hint.
No.
Just a little.
I just can't.
Come on.
No, it's better.
All right, interview's over. No more camera.
Oh, my gosh. Is that a camera?
No.
Oh!
Whoa. Well, I guess that wraps things up, huh? I learned two things today. A father's love for his son can overcome all obstacles. And always remember to put the camera in a shark cage, huh? Well, remember as always, you're watching me, so I'm watching you.
Oh, help me! I'm trapped in your TV!
Come on!
Mr. and Mrs. Jellyman.
Awesome.
Whoa! Big Old Blue's one serious place, dude.
That is one totally tight crew! Awesome!
Dude!
I don't know if I know what they know they are, but when I know, they'll know, you know.
The news does travel swiftly, my man.
Righteous!
Whoa! Jellyman and Little Blue inside the belly of the big one.
Dude, that is one gnarly little girl.
Little Blue was like, whoa! And Jellyman was like, whoa! But Little Jellyman was like, whoa, my head.
There's the curtain. Let's be thankful this time it was just a little one.